please rise as you're able and let us sing this morning as we begin our worship service. Journey to Milwaukee to love and serve others as the Lord loves us. We were reminded of a story that Jesus told in John. The night before Jesus was betrayed, he got up from the table, took off his outer robe, picked up a towel, and washed the feet of each disciple. It was an act of service and an act of love. Jesus knew where each foot had been and where each was going. He knew the path that they had walked for good and for ill. And yet, as he held each foot in his hand and wiped each clean, he forgave and he loved. Let us pause to review this past week and the week to come. Let us ask God to forgive our sins, to guide our path forward, that we might walk in Christ's ways of love and service to others as Christ has loved us. Hear the good news. Jesus knows where your feet have trod, for good and for ill as well. In the waters of baptism, Christ washed you clean, forgives you, and names you as beloved children of God. You are forgiven and set free to love and serve God with your lives. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Foundation of Christ's mercy and grace. As we grow, help us to grasp how wide, high, deep, and long Christ's love is for us. Remind us that Christ's love is wiser than human wisdom and stronger than human strength. Grounded in his love, teach us to love and serve others. In Jesus' name, amen.
Please be seated. Welcome to worship this morning, and thank you for supporting our youth as they journey to Milwaukee. They are here to share the stories of their trip and to share some of the reflections and things that they learned along the way as we worship this morning. There are several announcements in your bulletin to draw your attention to. This is Camp Week for American Lutheran. We have lots of students attending Bible camp this week. I will be attending camp with them and floating sort of back and forth in between here and there. So if you need to get a hold of me, if you have my cell phone number, call it. And if you don't have my cell phone number, well, you can get it. I'll give it to you. Like, it's not a big secret. But otherwise, call the office and Tiffany will find me. I won't be too far away. So let's see. And if you want to write notes to our kids, their information for how to send emails and mail at camp is in our bulletin. It's also time to get ready for Vacation Bible School. That is happening at the end of this month, the beginning of next. So sign up for that now. We are in need of adults to help do pretty much anything, right? Talk to Michelle if you're interested in helping. VBS is, I don't know, I think it's one of the most fun weeks of the whole year. So if you're an adult and you think, gosh, I'd like to go to Vacation Bible School, we will find a job for you and you can come, okay? Also, we're going to try something new this year. It's called Kids Ignite, because you see Vacation Bible School is explode, so now we're going to ignite with Jesus' love. Yes. And Ignite is going to be like a fusion. This is Lauren's word. It's awesome. fusion of Vacation Bible School and Joyful Noise. Boom. And its idea is to get us prepared for the school year ahead. It will be on Tuesday evenings. We'll have some games and some stories and some activities and a lot of great music, and on we go. So sign up for that as well. We'd love to fill our church on Tuesday nights with kids singing and having fun together. And it's for elementary age kids of all sorts. And if you're older than elementary, I'm sure we'll find a job for you, right, Lauren? Yeah. All right. Let's see. I think those are the big announcements. We are lucky because we have Melissa here from Secondhand Pets, and she's going to tell us about our cause of the month.
Good morning, and thank you for having me. I'm with Second Chance Pups. We are a prison dog training program rescue. So we take shelter dogs from shelters in eastern Nebraska and place them with inmates at the Nebraska State Penitentiary for 9 weeks of basic obedience training. So we look for dogs that are likely not being adopted because they need basic training and they don't have a lot of manners. We place them with the inmates who then train the dogs, and we guide them through that 9-week process, and then we adopt them out to good homes. So everybody kind of wins in our program. The dogs get a good home and get some training. The inmates learn a lot about just taking care of something other than themselves and how to appropriately do that, and following rules and just lots of different responsibilities that come with having a pet. And then the dogs get training, and so the people who adopt them get kind of a well-trained dog to start off their journey as well. So we're a very small organization. We are all volunteers, so we run solely based off of donations and adoption fees. So that's a little bit about our program. I appreciate that you selected us for this month's donation. That's huge for us. So I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
And I think on the table out in the narthex, Melissa left pictures of dogs that are currently up for adoption.
Yep.
Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah. If you have any more questions. What a wonderful ministry, though, huh? It sounds like a win-win-win-win. So thank you for that, Melissa. And this time I'd like to call on Luke, because he has a couple of words he'd like to share, and then we'll continue with our worship.
Well, good morning. First off, I'd like to have you guys give yourselves a round of applause and these kids a round of applause, because without you guys' support, without you guys, we couldn't do what we do. And what they did was absolutely amazing. Almost all of them are here. Morgan couldn't make it today because of car problems. So when you see her, ask her about her stories, because she had a blast there too and did a lot of things. But you're going to hear about what these kids had done their week in Milwaukee. What you're not hearing from them is the impact that they had on the community when me and Pastor Carla would sit back and just watch them. There was many times that the community that we were serving, they would just stop what they were doing and smile at what these kids were doing, just by being who they are, because of the support and the culture and the love from all of you people out here. They truly went out to these service sites and showed what it was to be servant leaders and to show how to love like Jesus. So thank you. Thank you, all of you guys, for all your support. And thank you, youth, for all your hard work.
Good morning. If you ever ask our youth group to make you a meal, you have two options and two options only. Those two meals are breakfast pancakes, bacon and eggs, or a spaghetti dinner with salad and bread. We know what we're good at and we stick to it. These two meals have always kept our bellies full on mornings of mission trips, at church events, and more. Yet there always seems to be a deeper connection between our group after our meals are finished. Community. Each of us pick a task, whether it be cutting fruit, flipping pancakes, or scrambling eggs. Everyone contributes a small part of a big meal that we all get to share together. This idea of community was something that really came up a lot on our trip. One really cool example of this was on one of our first days when we stayed at Bethlehem Lutheran Church in the community of Chicago. They graciously provided us with a place to stay for the night, and we joined them for worship in the morning. In a congregation that had scarce youth, the members of the church were so excited to have a group of energetic teenagers to join them for worship. We were flooded with loving messages like, "We are so happy to have you here," and "It's great to see kids like you wanting to do good in the community." When the time came for the children's sermon, only one little girl from the congregation went to stand up. All 12 of us looked at each other at the same time and were thinking the same thing. We stood up and went to go sit with her so that she didn't have to sit at the children's sermon all alone. This trip was full of beautiful moments just like this, of all of us working together and supporting each other as community, together as brothers and sisters in Christ.
Our first reading today comes from the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, verse 14 through 21. Not too short. For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth takes its name. I pray that, according to the riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is breadth and length and height and depth, and to know that the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than we can ask or imagine, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations forever and ever. Amen.
Everyone then who hears these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on a rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on the house, but it did not fall, because it had been founded on a rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against the house, and it fell. And great was its fall.
During our mission trip, our theme was being rooted in Christ and how our faith was like a tree that grew as we reached deeper and further into Christ. This meant that if our roots were not very deep and strong, then it would be hard to recover from the bad storms that come throughout our lives that might push our tree of faith and tear down some of our branches, such as the people we love dying, others being mean or unkind to us, or even when life is just not going our way. Also, it would be impossible for us to grow a deep and strong connection with Christ. One way to deepen and strengthen our roots that really stuck out to me was putting God first and putting his words into practice. For me, that meant doing my devotionals every day, even after the mission trip was over, giving it my all in everything that I do, and loving my enemies. Furthermore, I knew those things are pretty difficult to maintain, especially if you haven't been doing it all the time. But that's when I realized that in order to have a deep and strong connection with God and strong roots, you will need to work hard sometimes and do things you've never done before, like forgiving those who have hurt you, giving it your all in everything that you do, and reading God's word to understand his teachings and better connect with him on a personal level in order to strengthen your roots. All these new teachings made me understand and really appreciate and help me strengthen my relationship with Christ to deepen my roots. And it really helped me see things in new ways and will help me throughout my life.
rise and sing together. First Corinthians 13. If I speak in tongues of mortals and angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give myself away, give away my possessions and hand over my body that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
At YouthWorks, all of us are given a small devotion book that revolves around the theme of the year. During our personal devotion time, the book leads us through thoughtful and meaningful conversations with God. The scripture passages made me stop and really think about what they were saying and what they meant to me. For me, the time we had for personal devotions was a time I could really let go of my troubles and pain and just enjoy the time I was spending with God. Everywhere we went on the trip, we prayed. We prayed during every meal, before each service day. We prayed for the people we helped and for God to fill us with His Spirit and open our hearts and minds. Each prayer, no matter how long or how deep, were very meaningful and always filled my heart to the brim. My favorite prayers, though, were the ones that our church group did together on the last night. We all gathered together and thanked God for each individual, each of us adding something heartfelt and meaningful that they loved and treasured about the other. I'll always remember that. My favorite thing about our nightly worship services was definitely the music. There is really something about singing with a bunch of people that you've just met about God and how meaningful that is. That just, I don't know, you can't really find that feeling anywhere else. On the second night, almost all of us had connected in a sort of half circle, linking arms and singing together. Moments like that didn't really start until the end of our past few trips, but that day was like instantaneous. For our service days, we went to quite a few places and met so many amazing people. For the first half of the service, we'd go do manual labor mostly. We did a lot of weeding, cutting up trees, and overturning soil. We were clearing the way for new growth and for space to be used for other things. For the second half, we went to the VMP Community Care Center. We helped the activity center with paintings and drawings, like stuff for a party that they were going to do for the residents. We also got to go and hang out with the residents. We got the privilege of listening to their stories and playing games with them. I myself formed a connection with a very sweet and loving woman named Cora. I am so glad that God had led me on this mission trip to meet amazing people and to serve respectfully and love authentically.
We went to this place called Alice's Garden. We pulled weeds for the most part, but we also got to talk to this girl who owned a square of a plot. I learned a little about her and what she did. She took over the plot from Venice, so she still has some of her plants in there, but it's all mostly hers. While we ate lunch, Venice talked about the history of the place and how it started out. In 1972, 20 years following the destruction of neighborhoods, a garden was established in the space of 21st and Garfield. In 2001, Alice Medea Taylor, who was a longtime advocate for urban community programs within Milwaukee, passed away, and the garden on Garfield finally received its name. At the end of the time we were there, we all learned some things about the garden.
Every day after our morning activity, whether it was Alice's Garden, Adullam, or the Hunger Task Force, we went to a nursing home. This nursing home was fairly large and had independent living, assisted living, and the nursing home. They had about 500 residents in total. For the first hour of our time there every day, we helped them prepare for their big end-of-the-summer party. Half of us worked on painting smaller things, and the rest of us painted a brick background for a large cardboard train. After that, we went up to help with activities in the nursing home. For every activity, we had to help round up all the residents that would participate. Most all of the residents were in wheelchairs, so it sometimes took a little bit. On Monday, we took them all outside to a nice shaded patio area. One of the staff members sang and played the guitar for them, and they sang along. I wheeled out a guy named Mike and sat next to him. He was very social and nice. I hung out with him for the rest of the days that week. The second day, we took them into the cafeteria area to play a horse racing dice game. They seemed to like it, just not as much as the other activities. Then on Wednesday, we played bingo. They had fire in their souls and were very competitive. It was really fun to watch. Then on the last day, we took them into the cafeteria to have them listen to a guy that came in to sing and play guitar for them. Between that Monday and Thursday, we probably heard the Ring of Fire at least 3 or 4 times. We brought the residents back to their rooms and said our goodbyes. And we had a lot of fun getting to know some of the residents and doing fun activities with them. Overall, it was a great experience.
Adolam is a nonprofit in Milwaukee. They do a range of things to help the community, from providing housing to selling custom furniture. Adolam is helping Milwaukee. I have many great memories from serving at Adolam, like the little orange cat that became our mascot while we weeded in the front of the building. That cat was one of the little things that kept us going during the mission trip. Another great memory I have is the party we went to. Adolam invited us to eat good food and listen to live music as a thank you for the work we did. People from our church got on stage and sung and played instruments. I really enjoyed serving God at Adolam and making great memories.
On Thursday morning, we went to the Hunger Task Force farm. And it's a farm where they go and they just grow and provide food to people who can't afford it. And there is where we weeded green bean crops. And we had like a lot of fun doing it. It was pretty enjoyable. It was almost a competition. Who was the fastest green bean weeder there? Yes. The people who were there were actually really hopeful and friendly. They even explained to us like the history of the farm and how it was once a prison farm and how it came to be a place that provides food. It was cool to see the work we were doing, but it was especially cool to see the work they were doing. You know, yeah, it was really fun. I liked it.
Please rise as you're able and let us pray together.
All right, I have to go up.
Too close.
Too far. Good enough. Gracious God, we give thanks for your love that roots us in forgiveness and grace, for your congregation that stands together and nurtures faith, and for the families that practice faith at home and share your love with the community around us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we thank you for all the leaders and volunteers in our lives that you give us to help bring us together and use our strength in numbers to accomplish tasks and goals such as fundraisers for our youth so that we could go on our mission trip to spread your word to help others. Lord, I also thank you for giving us, our leaders and volunteers, the skills to help bring us together and support us in the things we may not have the skills for, like our rescue workers and community organizations that are trained and experienced in matters that we can't handle on our own, like firefighters and people that work in the hospital that have skills not everyone possesses. Finally, Lord, we ask you to keep giving those people the strength they need to keep up their amazing work so that we may all be safe. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Dear God, please help all the organizations that we've helped and supported to flourish and spread your love to others, and help what we've done and will do to make a difference for the better at home, in Milwaukee, and anywhere else that we have or haven't yet served. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for the kids going off to Carol Joy Hauling Camp this week. May they safely enjoy their time there, and may they grow in their faith.
Gracious God, we give thanks for the beauty of your creation. Especially we give thanks for the water that we got to visit on the trip to Milwaukee. Watch over Lake Michigan and all of the great lakes. We pray for those who are experiencing flooding of all kinds. Watch over those neighborhoods and those communities. And Lord, bless them and help them to be community for each other so that they can survive and struggle through the storms together. Send your grace and support along this journey. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, please help those who are struggling, especially who are sick, homeless, recovering from the storms, and who are struggling with age and health. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, I pray that as children of God, we remain rooted in the firm foundation that is God's love, and that we all remain grounded in him. All this we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
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 The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Also with you.
Please turn to your neighbors and share that peace today. Please rise as you're able and let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self, and you've called us to a feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, your body for the life of the world. Amen. Christ invites us to this table, and here we receive all that we need. Christ loves us so much that he washes our feet and makes us clean. He loves us so much that he feeds us with his very self. He loves us so much that he dies on the cross to forgive us of our sins. He loves us so much that he rises from the dead to give us new and eternal life every single day. So we gather at this table and we receive his grace, his forgiveness, his love. And then we are sent forth to love and forgive and share with each other. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The meal is ready, and all are welcome at this table. Please come forward as the ushers give instruction today.
May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you forever in his grace and love. Amen.
Enough wine.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you forever in his grace and love. Amen. Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As we have been nourished in this meal, now strengthen us. Now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray.
Amen.
At this time, I would invite our young students to come forward for a Bible camp blessing. All those who are heading to Carol Joy Holly. And it's one of my favorites because you probably all know by now how much I like to journey. This psalm was written for people who are heading and journeying to the temple of God in Jerusalem. And to get there, they know that they have to climb a rather large hill. They know that there is going to be potentially dangerous things along the road. And so they start out by gathering with their community, a lot like our church family. And as they do, they ask the question, I lift my eyes to the hills, that's where they're headed, from where will my help come? And then they answer with the stories that they have learned in Sunday school and so forth. They say, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. And then the community, look at the community, see them? The community reinforces it and says, yes, the Lord will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will not slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. He will not strike you by day nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. He will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore. And it was a prayer and a reminder that no matter where we go, always God goes with us. And as we go with God, and God blesses our journeys always, we never travel by ourselves, even when we sometimes feel like we're by ourselves, because there's this community of people who love you, who pray for you. Look at the back. Chris is waving at you. She's got her heart. Who are encouraging your journey, and who, even though they're not standing right by your side, they've got your back because you are children of God and God loves you. But it comes, it's a mixed thing, right? Because on the one hand, you are prayed for and encouraged. On the other hand, you're part of this community. So wherever you go, you bear this community with you. So you're all headed off to Bible camp. You're taking all your friends with you off to Bible camp. Did you know that? Did you know that? They are all going to Bible camp too. Through you. Woohoo! Wendy's excited. Now that means that when you're at camp, you should ask yourself, what would Wendy think of this activity? If you're thinking, I don't know if I want to climb that tower, Wendy is down on the bottom going, let's go! Because she's that kind of person, okay? So if you think, I don't know, give it a shot, because the camp wouldn't put you up for something that they don't have your back for. And this experience is part of the joy of the journey, okay? And if you're in your cabin and one of your friends wants you to do something that you know that Michelle would not think is a great idea, because she's taught you in Sunday school, you know it. You know that Pastor Carla would not think that that is a fabulous plan, then don't do it. And better yet, be the kind of leader that Lauren would teach you to be and say, this is not a fabulous plan, in the kindest possible way, because Lauren always does it in the kindest possible way. Okay? Be that person. Know that this congregation is part of you. And when you go to camp, bring this congregation with you to camp and let the Lord guide your journey through all that you learn. Let's pray. Gracious God, thank you for these students and for all that they will learn on the adventures ahead of them. Thank you for this congregation who helps fund camping ministry and who helps provide a way for each one of these students to go. And Lord, when they come back, help us to help them to bring back the stories and the joy that they learn along this way, and use the love that you've given them in their day-to-day lives at school and at play and in all that they do. In Jesus' name we pray all these things. Amen. Let's go in faith. We go with God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thanks for coming up this morning. I have to tell you a story, though. If you ever, like, feel the need to clap in a song, do it. It's just that when God made me as of your pastor and God handed out coordination genes, he skipped me entirely, and I cannot sing and clap at the same time. I get off beat, and then, like, I screw up the whole song. So please, please, please just, you know, do your clapping thing, because I love it. It's just I can't do it. So if you're ever wondering. Okay. Let us go in peace, to love, and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And as we go, one more quick little story. You might want to sit, because it might be a little. So, one of the very fun things that we got to do on this trip, we didn't just work the whole time. We had some fun, too, and you should really ask the kids about some of the really fun things that we did just for the fun of it along the way. One of the fun things that we got to do was to go to Lake Michigan and just hang out, have an evening hanging out on the lakeshore. And it was a blast, but it kind of was a kind of sort of windy-ish night. Well, actually, it was a really windy night. So windy that we didn't really want to go swimming in Lake Michigan because it's cold. But anyways, Luke climbed up on this overlook area and, like, had a look at the landscape around and was enjoying it. And then the wind came and got his brand new John Deere hat, like, brand new. Now, I got to tell you that, like, the cardinal rule of mission trips, there's a rule. Never, 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 never pack anything new. It's a cardinal rule. Just don't do it. But anyways, we were going to John Deere. That was another one of the fun things that we did. And Luke got a brand new John Deere hat for the experience. And then the wind said, it's a beautiful hat, and took it away and put it in Lake Michigan, never to be seen again. We did learn about polluting the lakes on this trip also. Just saying. Anyways, we found the hat. And we brought it back for him. And we want to give him a great round of applause for not just being a great sport, because he is a great sport all the time, but also especially for the one-on-one conversations that he has with our youth. Because I think that if you ask any of them, they can tell you a story where, like, he's just been one of those people who have guided their lives, and it is a gift and a blessing. So, hat. Don't bring it on the next mission trip. Or wear it so much that by the next mission trip, it's totally worn in. It won't be new anymore, exactly. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.